The fence line trail is now halfway done. We are putting all efforts doing it, and it's going well. But now the monsoon is on its way, and it has sent us a deadly trailer through a cyclone. Also, this was the reason for no video last week, and these were the results of the cyclone. This broken branch on the roller and this half destroyed lip. Also, the swimming pool after the cockpit gap. You can just jump off from the cockpit, bail off your bike in midair and dive into the pool. So in this video, I'm going to share some trail maintenance tips so you can preserve the trails for which you have put tons of efforts.
So the maximum water has dried out and there is a small pit here which is caused by the berm. So we'll make a drainage for it. Also, we'll make a drainage for this whole area which was just filled like a pool yesterday. So let's get to the work.
Firstly, your trail must have a proper drainage, which was lacking in my condition, so we'll make one. The place where water will most likely puddle up is the berm, and we have one on the lowest possible elevation on a property. I digged a trench which will lead the water to exit our property, but the problem is that we have a planted fence and the landscape looks somewhat like this. There is a hump on which the plants are planted. I have dug a trench till here, and to make the water flow further, either I have to dig this part all the way down and let the above tree die, or I have to take a big drill machine and make a hole in this hump and save the tree. The second option was saving the tree, so I went with it. But what about the big drill machine? The best part was the rain had made the soil wet, so it was easy to dig a hole in the bank. So I took a metal pipe and hammered it through the bank and gradually increased the sizes of the pipe.
And pipe just came out here.
After having an enough large hole, I have also brought a pipe to bury in the trench. Secondly is covering the feature. You must cover your feature with the help of a jute mat or a tarp, which will protect your feature from destruction by the raindrops. Here I had covered the berm with a jute mat, so it sustained the storm. If you use jute mat, you can ride the feature without removing it. Just remember to cover the feature nicely, or else...
Oh shit, I had covered the ramp here, but half of the plastic just went off. And only half of the ramp is fine here.
Now the dirt is wet, and let's use this soft dirt to our advantage by building a dirt feature. Our berm is turning us more than we need, but it's fun to ride, so I don't want to destroy it and rebuild it. So to compensate with that, we'll make a shark fin hip which will turn us back again to the line. To build the shark fin, I'm using two logs as the structure, and then I'll cover it with dirt. I also bought some boulders to make the transition.
Change in plan. We are making the shark fin slide to the left, so we can use this natural bank as landing, so we won't need to make another landing there. So I have slided the log here, we'll slide another log here, and then we'll put on the dirt.
I still don't know how to jump a hip, and it's an important skill in mountain biking. Hopefully this jump will make me better in jumping a hip. When you are building a dirt feature, try to put as many rocks as you can, as I did. This makes your structure sturdy and needs less dirt.
The shark fin is ready.
Because of the wet dirt, the worm was catching all my speed and I was not able to carry much speed to the shark fin. The next day, after everything dried out, I added some good packable hero dirt on the shark fin, which I found just beside the shark fin. This dirt just packs awesome, and after packing the dirt, now it's time to session it. Suddenly, it started raining very heavily, so I ran home with my bike and I forgot to cover the shark fin, so I came back quickly and covered the shark fin. Sadly, we were not able to session this shark fin. We'll definitely session it in next video. So hope you like the video and consider subscribing to my channel. I will be posting such trail building and MTB related videos every week.